So I'm Nele Per Jongeling, mainly known as Per Jongeling as my artist name. And I am a German comic artist. I recently published Emilia, my second book, which is now out in France as well. I wanted to talk about the topic of detransition because I am affected myself. That's autobiographical work. So I made the experience that when I first realized, okay, I think my transition into another gender wasn't the right choice for me, I figured that there are many resources on detransition. And I have already published a comic book on being transgender and on like a small introduction into the topic. And for me it was clear, okay, now I am not transgender anymore and I want to make another work that talks about detransition. I was really motivated to do this book because I can see that there are a lot of people who do a detransition and who feel like they're completely alone and there is no one else out there. And I'm just glad that I can give a resource and something where other people can see themselves and know, okay, it does happen. And also for people who are considering a transition or who are transgender, just to know, okay, this topic is out there as well and there is no threat and we can talk about it and without invalidating any identities. I think that any kind of extremist perspective is just really harmful to any kind of minority. And I think that it's really important, and that's what I'm trying to do with Emilia, is to show that we can disagree and that there is no only good and only bad. I think that's what's happening a lot, and especially in social media activism, that you see one truth and anything else is like bad and evil. And I think I really wanted to just give a space to make people have a space to raise questions and to realize, okay, there is also, in between all of this, there's also gray matter, there's also a variety of opinions, and as long as we know that our ethics and our values are the same and we respect all human beings, it's a difficult topic to talk about alternatives to deal with gender dysphoria, I think, because for a lot of people it is clear if you have gender dysphoria, there's only one way to handle it, and that is a transition, a medical and like physical transition. And well, I think that, you know, I think there can be people who can be happy with this transition. I think we can't sell a one-size-fits-all solution for all people who experience gender dysphoria. I think we are, even though it is a minority, we are a very diverse group of people, and we just need to offer all kinds of different possibilities and just the hope. I think that when I went to therapy with my gender dysphoria, it was presented to me as the only option to start hormones and have surgery. And I thought, if there is nothing else, I don't have any solution. I was also suffering from suicidal thoughts, and I was like, okay, this is the only way for me to survive. And if a medical professional would have told me, no, there are alternatives, and we have actually evidence of the fact that there are people with gender dysphoria who manage to get through with it also without a transition, then I think I would have been much more open to consider other alternatives that might have less irreversible effects on my body. I don't think that I write comics to really educate people. I don't like saying, okay, here, this is the information and this is what you should be doing or should be thinking. And because even on simple things, just as terminology, when talking about transgender people, there are huge differences in what words to use and what not, depending on context, country, opinion. So what I want to do with my art is to really just share insights of personal experience and give people the space to think for themselves and to understand and have respect and empathy towards people who are suffering from gender dysphoria or any kind of other problems in their life. throughout my entire transition, and even before, I was always doing sketchbooks and drawing a lot, and I noticed that visual communication is kind of the best communication of mine, to just really draw my feelings and not think about it, just put it on paper. So when I was doing Emilia, I was looking through all my sketchbooks and the scribbles and drawings that that inspired me, and then I was able to be like, okay, this actually is quite a good representation of this emotion that I want to show here, so I can use it now. And I was also influenced by dreams, actually. I often had this dream that I looked into the mirror and suddenly I had huge breasts, or they would just grow and be abnormally large and everything. And it was like horrible nightmares, and I drew them. And so I think that it's like a mix of just scribbling in sketchbooks, always like kind of scribbling my emotions, and then also using what my head already is producing when I'm asleep. It's half autobiographical, so like the entire setup is kind of made up, but the experiences of the main characters are my own, and the feelings. And so I like adding small things from my personal life. For instance, she is always going to the forest when she is thinking about her gender identity and is feeling kind of lost. So it's this metaphor of being lost in the forest, but it also goes together with my first publication on the topic of being transgender, where I used forest and plants, everything like this, to kind of show the difficulty to understand and see straight in all this mess of topics and thoughts and terms and everything. And then later, Emilia is leaving the forest and she's going to the sea at a dike. And my reference there was actually my hometown, because I grew up at the sea. And yeah, it was kind of coming to terms, coming home and having like a look at the sea and seeing clear and really far. And I like being inspired from small things and just always thinking, okay, what is from my personal life? What can I take to put in here right now? I'm now working on a new project. It's like still quite rough. It's like generally talking about work and the pressure to always be productive. So I am focusing on other topics as well, besides gender. And yeah, this is my current progress.